Something funky's going on. Will you look at that? Hey, I got you're dead now.
Hey, listen. Those two, you are aware that you have...
You talking about my parents?
Well, that is... Those are your parents?
That's what I said, isn't it? Mom, Dad, look who's here. I told you he wouldn't take the food and run. I know you're hungry.
Listen, kid. You know what it means to transform, right?
What, do you think I've been hiding under a rock? Of course I know.
That's good. So, your parents, they're not with us anymore. They've transformed.
No way! Look! Hey, Dad, you hungry?
But they're virals. That could be dangerous for you.
I'll handle them. Meanwhile, let's get down to business. I told you if I hired you for the mission, I'd pay you. Got the food?
Right. Here.
Awesome. Thanks. Here, Mum. Here, Dad. Enjoy. Bye now. See you tomorrow. Don't worry. I'll be back to feed you again. And here you go. This is the super weapon. My dad won't be needing it anymore. Thanks again. My parents are also grateful, as you can see.
Thank you.
Let him talk.
I've heard enough of this crap.
You better not be here stirring up people's hopes.
I understand. I really do. But I'm telling the truth. I found a cure for THV.
We're listening.
I'm looking for Astragalus frigatus and Uncaria tomentoser.
What are those?
Plants.
What are you gonna do with them?
Before the fall, I was a doctor. I specialized in alternative medicine.
I'll take any medicine these days.
When I came to Villador, they didn't even have any AM practitioners. I made a lot of money. This was in 2020. Then in 22, the THV pandemic hit us. Most people thought it would last a few months, a year tops. We had seen pandemics before, right? We'll learn to live with it. This ain't the first pandemic. It'll be back to normal soon. Remember thinking that?
I hadn't been born yet.
And then, they locked down Berlin, deployed the army in Paris, New York, one city after another. Satellites went dark. The internet went offline. That was the worst for a lot of people, huh? Until the power went out. Everywhere. But Villador held on behind its walls, and I kept my doors open, seeing everyone I could. Doing my best, even when all other cures failed.
And what was that?
What was what?
Your best. What was it you actually did?
Traditional remedies, inspired by Indian shamans and Siberian folk healers. Ancient recipes found in Babylon and Assyria, healing the body and the mind. I never gave up hope. I realized everyone working on a cure was making a fundamental mistake. They were entirely focused on biology and chemistry.
You mean? science.
They were ignoring the bounty of nature. With my vast knowledge of botany, I decided to look for the answer in the plant world.
Wait, now you're a botanist?
After getting seeds from the now destroyed seed bank building in Elysium, and after 4 years of intense work, I made a cure for THV.
You made a cure?
Okay, yeah, sure. If that's true, where are all the people you cured?
I was only able to cure 4 patients before my lab was raided and destroyed by bandits. They killed all my patients. Right in front of me. Destroyed my work.
So, let me get this straight. You, an alternative medicine doctor, made a plant-based cure in a lab that was then raided by bandits, who then killed all your patients, but left you alive and didn't snatch you or your miracle cure.
You don't have to believe me.
Oh, I don't.
I believe you.
Which is why I spend all my time wandering the city, hoping to find somewhere Astragalus frigidus and Caria tomentosa, and the other plants I need to recreate the cure.
I truly hope you find them one day.
Son of a bitch! sure you want to do this? Back the fuck up! You're a dead man! Gonna nail ya! Take it down! Looking for trouble? Let's play cat!
Oh.
Bam!
Hey, Henkel, I'm at the monument. You were right. Not much left of it.
Good. Look closely. There is much more to it than meets the eye.
Ready for this?
There's a plaque here. Oof, a lot of names on it. Are those the victims of a massacre?
Yes, 64 names. Things was starting to get pretty bad outside the walls around then, and the army needed more weapons. So they confiscated the civilians' weapons. Private ownership of any sort of firearm and its ammunition was forbidden thereafter.
Something's off. Who do we have here? Dead.
What happened here?
That is where the riots started. People were terrified. How could they protect themselves and their families? There was massive unrest. So, a curfew was put in place. And homes were raided to ensure no one was hiding any weapons. Punishment for those who didn't comply was quite severe.
Shots were fired.
The army started shooting at people. Panic broke out. And of course, things only got worse. The riots escalated. It was the beginning of the end. Light the candle.
Inhibitor container detected.
So you're saying that Pratt made a bad call, taking people's guns away?
Hard to know for sure. But it didn't end well for anyone. In fact, the main irony is that the army soon ran out of ammunition. And just like that, firearms became obsolete. At least, that's what's generally believed to have happened. Now, you'll hear some folks claim that Pratt kept a secret stash of ammunition somewhere in the city. But if so, he took that secret to the grave. So I guess we'll never really know. And that's the thing about history. We rarely ever really know. It's not a hard science. History is fragile as the passing of time. It takes the vigilance of people like myself to make sure it's not rewritten to suit the whim of each new generation's self-righteous fight. The duty of remembrance. Everyone should practice it. Farewell now, Pilgrim. I hope this little trip down memory lane has illuminated your path.